Welcome. Today, I'm going to talk about the open category. The open category is the main reference for most recreational flights and all low-risk commercial activities. It is divided into three differentiated subcategories depending on the type of operation to be carried out. The three subcategories are known as A1, A2, and A3, which can be summarized according to European Aviation Safety Agency as follows. The A1 scenario in which you can fly over people but not over crowds. The A2 scenario in which you can fly close to people. And the A3 scenario where you have to fly away from people. To create each of the subcategories, the European Aviation Safety Agency has made a risk pre-assessment and has set the limits that operators must follow in order to fly. Among these, we will find the pilot training requirements, safety distances, and the type of drone that can be used in each subcategory. For this reason, before going out to fly, it is important to identify in which subcategory we will classify the operations that we want to carry out, and thus, know what standards and requirements we must comply with. First, let's talk about A1 scenario. Drones with C0 class and private built with a maximum weight of 250 grams will have the following operational restrictions. You will be able to fly over uninvolved people with the operation, but not over crowds. You shall fly in visual line of sight. The maximum height for a flight is 120 meters above the ground. The operator registration is not mandatory unless the drone has a sensor capable of recording personal data. No official training is required, just reading the manual provided by the manufacturer. The A1 scenario also has drones with a C1 class. Drones with C1 class will have the following operational restrictions. Flying over people not involved should be avoided, and it is not allowed to fly over crowds. You shall fly in visual line of sight. The maximum height for a flight is 120 meters above the ground. The operator registration is mandatory for this class. Reading the manual provided by the manufacturer is required as well as completing the A1 A3 training and examination. Next up is the A2 category. Drones with C2 class will be able to fly in this category. The drones will have the following operational restrictions. You cannot fly over uninvolved people. Flying is allowed at a safe horizontal distance of at least 30 meters from non-participants. Every meter that you want to climb will force an additional one in horizontal safe distance. This distance can be reduced to a minimum of 5 meters if the low speed mode function is activated. You shall fly in visual line of sight. The maximum height for a flight is 120 meters above the ground. For this class, the operator registration is mandatory. Reading the manual provided by the manufacturer is required as well as completing the A1 A3 and the A2 training and examination. And lastly is the A3 category. Drones with C3 or C4 class and private built, flying in an A3 scenario will have the following operational restrictions. Flying near people is forbidden. It is required to fly a minimum of 150 meters away from urban areas. You shall fly in visual line of sight. The maximum height for a flight is 120 meters above the ground. The operator registration is also mandatory for these last classes. Reading the manual provided by the manufacturer is required as well as completing the A1 A3 training and examination. In addition, apart from the operational restrictions of each of the subcategories, the need to comply with the requirements for flight in controlled airspace and the specific coordination requirements of each specific location must be considered. For more information, visit the link in the description. Safe flights.